Good day everyone, welcome to Prime World Tutorials. My name is Oche Patrick and I'm going to be teaching you how to create an animated short story in PowerPoint. This tutorial is a short series, meaning that we have broken it down into various video clips. This is a preview of the full work we are going to be doing. So you can see this is the short animated story we are going to be creating throughout the series. So we are going to be referring to this work frequently. This is going to be our reference file so that we'll be using it throughout the course of this tutorial to create it afresh. So in this particular video, we are just going to be creating the graphic elements in the animated story. So let's get started. The first thing we are going to do is to create a new blank presentation. So you go to File, go to New, and you go to Blank Presentation. So currently we have a blank file because we want to start afresh. So the first thing we want to do is to get rid of these text boxes because we don't really need them for now. So you just click on an edge to highlight it or activate it and delete. Do the same for this and delete. So we now have a blank sheet. Now, referring back to our reference file, you can see that the first thing we should create is the background. Okay, because in any design work, the first thing you create is the background before you create the elements that will be on top the background. So the main background footages here or images here are the sky and the grass. So for a start, we are going to be creating the blue sky. So how do we do that? Let's go back to our fresh work. So the first thing we do to create the blue sky shape is go to the insert menu. After the insert menu, go to this option that says shapes. Then you choose this option that looks like a rectangle. It is actually a rectangle, so you click on it. Then in order to draw, it is now active for you to draw it. So in order to draw it, just go to where you want to start the drawing and click, left click and drag. So when you left click and drag, when you get to the point that you are satisfied with, you release your mouse. So it actually creates the shape. Now if you can remember from our reference photo, the shape, the color was kind of light blue, so we want to change this dark blue color to something lighter. For us to be able to do this, we need to go to this option that says format. Now this format option will not show except you are currently active on the particular shape. If I'm active away from the shape, because I clicked away from the shape now, you can see that the format menu has gone away. So you have to be active on a shape by clicking on it to make the format menu appear. So upon being in the format menu, you go to shape fill. Then you come here to this place that says thin colors and pick a lighter blue color. So I think this is how it was before. So I'll pick something lighter like this. I think this is okay. In fact, this is okay. So I click on it. Now the next option I'm going to do is I want to remove the outline. The outline is more or less the color of the border. The border color. The color of the border of the shape. If you can see, if you look closely, you see that there's a darker blue color as the outline. So I want to change it to no outline. I don't want it to have an outline at all. So I click on it. In the same format menu, I go to shape outline and I choose no outline. Now you can see that there is no more that thing, that color anymore at the edge. So the next thing I'm going to do is to create the grass, which is similar to creating the sky. So I go to insert, I go to shapes, I go to rectangle, and I draw. I go to shape fill, change it to green, a green color like this. I go to shape outline, change it to no outline. So as you can see, we have created the sky and the green grass. So the next thing we want to create is the house. As you can see from our reference, we have these two houses here. So we want to start by creating this house. So the first thing we are going to do is to create the body of the house. So we go to insert menu, go to shapes, choose this same rectangle tool, then you drag and position it right about here. Now the next thing we want to change is the color. We want to give it that light brownish color we had in the reference. You can give it any color you want, it's left for you. So we go to shape fill, we choose a brownish color, let's say this color, or okay, this color is okay. So we click on it, we go to shape outline, choose no outline. So we've created the body of the house. The next thing we want to create is the window of the house, and it's a similar process. We go to insert, shapes, choose rectangle again, click and drag until you create a box like shape here. Okay, now I just want to move it in a bit. If you want to move an object, you see this cross thing appearing behind the cursor. Once it appears, it gives you the sign that you can actually move it. So you just click and hold your left mouse, then you just drag it to the position you want. So I just want to move it in a bit like here. So the next thing I want to do is to change the color of the window to white. So I go to format, since I'm active on the window, the format is already showing. So I go to shape fill and I change it to white. Now the next thing I want to do is to give it a darker color, an outline that has a darker color. So I go to shape outline. The first thing I want to do is to increase the weight. So when I go to the weight option here, you see that as I scroll down, the weight of the outline is changing as you are observing from the window image. So I want to use this one that says 4.5 points. So when I click on it, you can see it has given it an outline, but I want to change the color of the outline. So I go to, yes, this is the color I'm looking for. I go to this dark brown color and click on it. So we've successfully created the window. Now the next thing we want to create is the door of the house. So we go back to the same insert, shapes. Now we choose this option that says round single corner rectangle. Round single corner rectangle. So I click on it and I drag until I form this. Then if I want to reduce the size of a shape, all I need to do is to go to the nodes at these edges. Go to any of the nodes at these edges, depending on the direction you want to reduce or increase it. So when you go to the edge of the node, you can see that the cursor changes to this shape. Then you just click and drag it to any direction you need it to be, and it reduces or increases it for you. So this is right about okay for me. Now the next thing, I want to change the color to the same color of the outline of the window. So I go to shape fill and I choose the same color. Now I don't want it to have an outline, so I click no outline. So you can see that we are making good progress already in creating the graphics for the animated story. Now the next thing we are going to do is to create the roof of the house. So similarly, we go to insert, go to shapes. Now we want to look for a shape that is like a right angle triangle, and this is it here. We are looking for this shape, and we found it. So we come here, draw the roof, and release our mouse. Now the next thing we want to do is to change the color to the same brown color so that it will match. So we go to shape fill, go to this color, and we choose it. We also want to remove the outline, so we go to shape outline and we say no outline. So currently you can see that we've successfully created the first house. So the next thing we want to do is to create the second house. Now you can decide to start from scratch this process that I just did in creating this first house, but in order to save time, there's a more excellent way to do it. All we just need to do is to duplicate this particular house and change the color of the house. So for us to be able to duplicate this whole house, the first thing we want to do is to group the house as one particular object, because currently the house is made up of several objects. So we want to group them into one particular object. So how we do that is we click on one of the objects. If you want to select multiple objects, you click on control in your keyboard, control. Now my hand is stayed on the control key. That's why, if you can see, the cursor has a plus sign beside it, indicating that I can select another element, including the one I've selected before. So with this, I'm clicking on this object, clicking on this other object, and clicking on the door object. Now you can see that I didn't remove the previous selections. It is selecting all of them at once because my hand is stayed on the control key. So I release my hand from the control key, and the next thing I want to do is to right click on my mouse. Right clicking from my mouse, I go to the group option and say group. Now as you can see, the object is now as one singular object. So the next thing I want to do is to make a copy of this object, this singular house object. How am I to do this? There are several ways to do this. You can right click, choose copy, right click on an empty space, and choose this particular option here, this first option that says paste. This first option, you choose it and it pastes it, and I can move it away from this. So this is the first step I can use. Let me undo this by pressing Ctrl Z. The second step I can use is to use the shortcut key. Click on it, press Ctrl plus C, hold down Ctrl and press C, then press Ctrl plus V, and it will paste it. Ctrl C is to copy, Ctrl V is to paste, and it pastes it for you. Okay, sorry. So that's the second step, Ctrl C and Ctrl V. But the quickest step, which is just a shortcut, a singular shortcut, is to duplicate it once, and the shortcut is Ctrl D. Just press Ctrl D and it duplicates it for you. Now we want to move it to this other direction. Now we need to flip it to the other end. So we go to this edge here. Once this shape shows, it means that we can drag it, and we just click and drag it to the other end. Now to be sure that it's the same size, we can move. Oh my god, it's moving. It's ungrouped. So it's moving it individually. We need to move it at the same time. So let's group this again. Okay, it's still grouped. It's just that you need to move it carefully so that it doesn't move a singular object. It moves everything. So you can see that it's the same shape. So we just place it at this other end. Now the next thing we want to do is to change the color. If you look at your reference, you can see there is a different color. So we come here. The first thing we need to do is ungroup it. Go to group, right click, ungroup. Then we go to the first, we click on the first shape. Okay, go to format, shape fill, change it to red. You can choose any color you want. Then we go to this next, the body of the house. Can change it to something pinkish. I think it was something pinkish. So let's see if, yeah, something like this. Okay, like something like this color. But if you want to see more color options, you can go to more fill colors in case you don't see the color you want, and you can pick from any of the colors here. So I've chosen to use this pinkish, like this pinkish like color. Press OK. Okay, well, it's too, the color is not really that good, so let me choose something else. Okay, let me settle for which color. Okay, let's just settle for this. So the next thing, we want to change the outline. We want to leave the body, the color of the window to be white. We want to change the outline to red. So we go to we click on the shape, go to shape outline, and we choose red. Now we want to change the color to the same red too, so we'll just quickly do that. Okay, no, not the outline, the fill. The fill, change it to red. And you can see now that we've successfully created the two houses. Let's go ahead and group these objects again so that they are a single. Units. So you can see that the houses are created. Now let's go back to our reference. The next thing we want to create are these elements, the three stars and the moon. So let's go ahead and do that. So for us to do this, we need to go to the insert menu, go to shapes, and look for the one that is like a star. Here it is, star. You can also choose this one if you prefer it, but I prefer this 5-point star. So I click on it and I just click and drag, but it formed on its own in this case. So I just position it to the shape I want it to be. I go to the shape fill, change it to white, shape outline. I don't want an outline. So instead of starting afresh, I just need to duplicate this. So I just press Ctrl D to get the other stars. So I place this, the third star here, and I place the second star right here. So you can see we've gotten our stars positioned. Now the next thing we want to do is we want to create the moon. So we go to the moon. Here it is. This is the moon-like shape. So we click on it and we drag. So as you can see, we want it to face the other direction, so we just flip it. We just flip it this way. We can also move it. Now we want to change the, okay, before we go to that, you can also change the rotation, or you can change the rotation direction of your shape. You just go up to this place that has a rotation sign, and you see that the symbol changes. You can now click and drag and decide to rotate it to any angle you want the shape to be. So that's how you can do it. But in this case, I just want it to be as straight as how it was before. So I now go to shape fill and make it white. Go to shape outline, make it no outline. So as you can see, we've come a long way. We have created all the shape elements for this animated story. So the next thing we want to do, okay, let me just position this back. The next thing we want to do is to create the text. we want to create the text for the footage, and the text says at night kids are in bed sleeping. So let's just do that. Now, for us to be able to insert text in our PowerPoint presentations, we have to first insert a text box. And how do we do that? We go to insert, we go to text box, we click on text box. Make sure that the text box is active. It's currently active now, so it means that you can draw the text box anywhere. So I click and drag, and it has drawn a text box. Then I can now type in the text I want. So I type at night I can decide to centralize the text and make it bigger. So for you to do anything on a text, you have to first highlight it. So I highlight it by pressing Ctrl A to highlight all inside the text, or I can click at an edge and just drag. Okay, no, make sure you are active on it first, then you click and drag to highlight it. Then the next thing I want to do is I go to the home menu. Then I want to change, I want to make it bigger, so I want to make it to be 28. Okay, then you can change the appearance of the text. You go to this place that says font, is the font face or font style. So I want to choose something like Adobe Gothic STD. I think it looks nice and cartoony. So let me change this at night, the I to small letter. Okay, so we have this. So we have inserted the first text. If you notice, in our reference, they were in separate text boxes. They have their own text boxes, so they are not in the same text box. So the next thing we want to do is to create the text box for kids are playing. You can simply go to insert text box and draw it, or you can, if you want to use the faster means, you just come and duplicate this one. Duplicate this at night, place it down, click inside, and just change the text. Kids are in bed playing. Then you can change it to white. Change the color to white. Go to home. This is the place to change font color. You can see it is written font color. So you click on this arrow beside the font color and change the color to white. Now we want to reduce it. So we want to reduce it to, let's say, 20. I think 20 is okay. 20 points. So you can see now we've successfully created the text for the graphic image. So that's it. That's basically it for this video. We said that we're only going to be creating the graphic elements for the video. So in our next video, we're going to be putting animations to these elements in our next video. Thank you so much for watching.